Hi all, welcome to Amrita IAS Academy. So today we will be having a trend analysis of economy and agriculture. So we had already completed our trend analysis on geography. So today we will be dealing with economy and agriculture. So some of you might think, why this agriculture? So actually implicitly the UPSC is not telling us agriculture in their syllabus, but if you go through the year's pattern and all, and if the changing pattern last 2-3 years, it is clear that agriculture as a separate distinct identity is asking a lot of questions. For example, questions from food processing is repeating, questions related to irrigation or questions related to the various kind of subsidies and its implication and all, water stress, all these things are actually related to agriculture as such. So if you look at some pattern last 2-3 years, about 4 questions as from agriculture is asking and remaining 4 questions from the other parts of economy. It include the public finance or budgeting or the various basic concepts of planning, mobilization of resources or the investment models. All these together are asking 4 questions and 4 questions from agriculture. So that's why we divided it into a separately in Indian economy except the parts that is from agriculture. So now we can look at the how it works or how the questions are being asked from various areas. So before that, this is a brief thing of how the marks has been asked. When you take GS3 as a, because GS3 very important, in GS3 compared to GS1 and GS2, if you have more idea or the if you are not updated with the current events or current affairs, there are high chances you will end up in less marks. And in that current affairs, economy is very important, because a lot of questions from economy, almost 90% of the questions are asked on from a current affairs perspective. For example, our economic survey become very important. Even the quotes from economic survey or certain words from economic survey itself has been asked as question by UPSC. So if you look at that pattern, or the food processing, changing trends in food processing, or the what is the impact of certain government initiative, for example a direct question on National Horticulture Mission, or the various methods of irrigation such as drip and sprinkler, all these things are asked from a current affairs perspective. So what the government thinks, or the for that matter economic survey and budget are very important, because that is the questions were asked from an analytical part based on that. That is why these days we can see the importance of GST. GST's last 2-3 years repeated questions has been asked, various aspects actually, sometimes direct question like 2019, which all taxes were subsumed to into GST, and in last year or the 2020 the question was like about the GST compensation cess because of the COVID issue. So that is why current affairs, unlike the GS1 and GS2, more importance to current affairs is required. And economy almost 100 marks, if you look at that, that is almost done. 40-45% of the marks will be from economy and agriculture. So we need to, unlike prelims, we need more analytical level of studies, and current affairs is very important. Just look at the pattern of the marks. That's why economy as such, except agriculture, 70 marks from 2013 and 40 marks in agriculture. To 2014, almost similar pattern has been following. 2015 and after 17, very important, because till 2016, you might know that 12.5 marks for every question. Each question has 12.5 marks. But 2017 onwards, that trend changed and the current pattern of 10 mark questions and 10 15 mark questions. So that itself shows that the changing pattern and the importance of agriculture, almost if you look at that, very important, because this 50 marks, compared to other parts of the economy. If you focus on agriculture, means that is because the government's agenda, that is why there is a clear vision of government of doubling farmers' income by 2022. Lot of associated schemes such as PM Fasal Bima Yojana, Krishi Sanjay Yojana, or the piped water connection tool, all these are linked, or the rationalization of subsidies. So a lot of activities are happening in agriculture sector, and we all know the recently passed farm bills, that itself shows the importance of agriculture. That is why if you focus, almost 50% of the marks from economies asked from agriculture and the rural economy. Agriculture means it includes a wider part of the rural economic development. What are that? That is why food processing, very important. You can see questions, almost repeated questions every year. Just change in pact or the just maneuverability in questions is happening. Almost the answer will be in a similar direction. What are the advantages or disadvantages? What are the challenges? Or what are the challenges regarding supply chain infrastructure or storage facilities? All these things are related directly or indirectly to agriculture and agriculture related industries, that is the what to say revival of rural economy is very important. That is why UPSC is focusing on agriculture. So this is the trend of how the marks have been divided into agriculture and economy. Now coming to syllabus, first we can discuss the syllabus of economy except agriculture. So coming to syllabus, the basic things, the Indian economy and the issues related to planning, growth, development, very important. Development and growth these days means sustainable development, or concept of equity. All these things are, UPSC is changing that pattern, not from a pure theoretical what we are studying is growth and development, they are changing to sustainable models of development. Questions related to that intergenerational equity, 2021 question was like, explain the intragenerational and intergenerational equity from the viewpoint of sustainable development. Very important, this kind of changing pattern is happening actually in UPSC. So these terms are very important. Growth means inclusive growth. So this area you need to focus, you can expect questions repeated last 2-3 years trend, that will clearly shows that UPSC is moving in that direction. Now coming to mobilization of resources, of course, what are the various methods government is adopting, lot of methods, all these things will be covered under mobilization of resources. Again, very important, government budgeting. I already told you about the role of GST, or the even certain taxes that has been announced in the budget, that is directly asked by UPSC. So for this area, this government budgeting, economic survey, very important. Without economic survey, without an analysis or reading of economic survey, you are not supposed to answer questions from this area properly. And budget, related to it is budget. While coming to economic survey, the volume 1 and volume 2, there is a general, we all know who are seriously preparing for UPSC and who are right, who are already written mains and all will be knowing that volume 1 is important for mains and volume 2 is important for prelims perspective. Because volume 1 actually give you what is the government wants, the government's agenda, or the what government needs in the economy, all these things. That is why the latest economic survey, the first chapter was saving lives and livelihoods amidst once in a century crisis. So they are talking about how this COVID can be made into an opportunity, how India manage it, all these things. So government wants that, government is focusing on that area. After that, what all investment will happen, what will be the changing investment climate, all what will be happening in the entire economic process of the world, all these things government want to analyze, and what is government need, what is the, or the what is government focusing on, all these things will be covered. So we can expect questions from volume 1 of the economic survey a lot of time. Or V-shaped recovery, how India was following or India is following a V-shaped recovery, you can expect questions from that area. So this way government budgeting is important. And also this year we can again expect, because the fiscal deficit charge or the target set by the under Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act, it all has been violated. Why? Because there was an escape clause because of COVID and all that target, all these are violated. So we can expect a question from that area, fiscal deficit, how India is managing, all is that can be an issue. So we need to approach all these areas analytically, that is very important. So that is why this government budgeting becoming very important. Now coming to investment models, that also again important, because earlier PPP was asked, now we are seeing this national ambitious program such as National Monetization Pipeline or the Gati Shakti, all these things will be important, that will be connected to infrastructure also, but it can be have some connections. Now coming to financial and money market, the usual things, the RBI policies, all these things, or the changes, what is happening in the capital market, if it is happening, that will be important. As compared to other areas, this is not much, we analyze the trend, we can see that. But compared to other three areas, or the Indian economy, issues related to planning, government budgeting, investment models, this is less important from a mains perspective, I'm telling, but it doesn't mean that we don't need to look at the basics. Basics are every time important, what we are covering in the monetary sector, RBI's role, or the monetary policy committee, or it will be related to this financial inclusion, all these things which is asked from a other perspective. So it can be linked with this financial and money market. Now coming to inflation, another area, actually no, that's a basic concept, basic concepts will be there, questions related to, because in 2019 one question was that, like Do you agree that steady GDP growth and low inflation have left Indian economy in good shape? These kind of things. What are the inflation targets? How it is affecting the economy? Is it good or bad? These kind of questions, direct questions you can expect. Now coming to direct and indirect tax, and again that is related to the government budgeting part. Inclusive growth and issues, that is also linked to the planning, growth, development and unemployment. So some lot of convergence you can see, many subjects also. Economy, we can see a lot of convergence with even the parts of agriculture that is important from a geography perspective, or some technology to the aid of farmers, because you can expect questions from how biotechnology or nanotechnology can improve the farmer's life, these kind of things, or entire ecosystem, how the technology can improve the taxation process, all these things also you can expect. So a lot of convergence is also there in economy's pattern of questions. Now coming to the syllabus itself, where all we can expect more questions, as in the syllabus itself, if we, what to say, decode the syllabus as such, we can expect questions from other areas, which includes role and objectives of Indian planning, Niti Aayog, very important. Now we have changed from the planning commission to Niti Aayog, so Niti Aayog reports itself become important. So these kind of questions you can expect. Okay, Niti Aayog planning means now we are changing from the planning commission to a indicative planning, or the just a think tank. There will be giving some signals to the economy, and the planning is done at a decentralized level. So the role of Niti Aayog, there are various reports how it is fostering the central state relations, like the health index or the education index or the water index. A lot of things Niti Aayog is doing, that will be very important. And the planning experience, these are related things. Regulatory role of the state, development strategy, India's 5-year plan. That is, anyway, we are now moved from this 5-year plan concept to a long term planning, but still there can always be a question on planning commission, Niti Aayog comparison. We can expect that, because almost one decade, 2015, the Niti Aayog has formed. Only one question has been asked from that part. We can always accept or the expect some questions from that area. This kind of talking to the vital role of public, this is not important now. Indian economic performance. This area very important, trends in saving and capital formation since independence. Coming to that, lot of questions from the invest, because directly one question was asked related in 2018, like the role of savings in Indian economy, or the how the savings can be changed to investment, or how the low saving level is affecting the growth of India. All these things, because we need investment, and government is in shortage of funds, private investment is that much is not coming. All these issues we need to analyze. So the role of savings trends, or the trends in saving and capital formation since independence, that will be important, because economic survey is covering these areas continuously, because we need more investment. So that area need a special focus. Now coming to resource mobilization part, there itself, what are the basic things we can focus on these areas? What are the types of resources? Physical and financial resources are there. Physical is more related to direct real sector development. Financial, it should come from stock market or the capital market changes. So that area is also important. And these things, sources of resource mobilization, public sector and private, we need that. That is very important, because disinvestment is happening. So the reduced role of state in enterprises, just as a regulator. Now state is focusing its role as just a regulator. We are seeing a lot of disinvestment targets, or the national monetization pipeline. All these things clearly shows the changing nature of how the state is performing. So we can expect that can be a potential area for a question, because economic survey clearly talked about the role of how the welfare state can be changed with more private participation. The private sector should be encouraged to invest, all these things. And we are seeing a lot of, like the Air India, recent sale of Air India, and also a lot of disinvestment of even the big public sector companies such as BPCL. All these things are happening. So this area is very important, as the changing role of this public sector and private sector, how government is formulating policies. Now coming to taxation and mobilization of resources for economic growth and direct tax, and this area every time, that like an evergreen area we can expect, because GST is there, changes in direct tax code is coming. And also one more thing is very important, there is an aim for a single corporate tax rate, which is beneficial for a nation like India, because we know about these issues of the taxation avoidance, a lot of litigation is happening, a lot of cases related to big firms and all. So this is good for nations like India and all. Same way, like the GST importance, the importance given to GST, you can expect a question from this area on the direct tax reforms and especially the single corporate tax rate suggested by the G7 nations, which has been approved by almost all the major countries. So that can be an area where questions can be expected. Now coming to mobilization of financial resources through government revenues, role of public debt, again very important, because this debt criteria, because that bad bank was formed, all these things will be very important from that perspective, because to reduce NPAs and all, the role of bad bank and all these things will be important, because PARA, that agency itself was being formed, and the impact, how it will be, you need to prepare from a both positive and negative aspects. What are the global trends related to these bad banks and all? So that is also another important aspect, bad bank. Now coming to role of fiscal and monetary policy resource mobilization, the general theory part, the static area, but it needs to be updated with the changing conditions, how COVID-19 has changed all these concepts, or if we need additional resource, all these things, what are the opportunities after COVID, how the monetary policies or the RBI manage the economy at the time of crisis, how government intervenes, even our vaccine policy, all these things can be asked from a economic perspective or the economy perspective. Related to it is the role of banks or the how the bad bank will be functioning. All these will be important. Now coming to multilateral agencies and resource mobilization, like the major static areas basically. Now coming to very important actually, inclusive growth and issues arising from it. Last 2-3 years, especially before that, it was not the trend, some direct questions, but now there is a question which is asking as a convergence of this area, because growth means, I had already told, it is inclusive growth. Development means sustainable development. Equity, intergenerational equity, intragenerational equity, all these concepts related to, even that is linked with how the economy environment linkage, very important. Questions from a economy environment linkage. Or environment economics as such, questions are being asked, how it is affecting our, or the how, what are the changes happening in our policy towards the development or the changing trends of development, our renewable energy targets, all these things. Now we know the COP26 at Glasgow is going on. It is also important from an economic perspective, because of our ambitious target related to energy, transportation and all these things will matter. So this area you can expect a lot of questions, because what is the basic concepts of inclusive growth or sustainable development? What are the other impacts like the intergenerational, intragenerational? All these things will be asked. Or how India manages its policies, or changing from a coal-based economy to a more renewable energy source economy. All these can be possible questions from this area. And also some of the schemes also you can expect questions, such as like the poverty alleviation and employment generation schemes as such, as for inclusive growth, such as PM Ujjwala Yojana, like the giving the pipe or the LPG connections to the poor people, BPL households, all these schemes, or the free electric, all the providing electricity to all people, changes in our subsidies policies and all these things. Or it can be linked with our Swachh Bharat Abhiyan or the Jal Shakti Abhiyan, all these things, how social sector development is using, or the changes in health and development, or the educational sector is important in achieving this inclusive growth, and all the challenges associated with it. Housing to all, very important. Again, 2022 was a target for provide housing to all. So all these areas, education, health and housing, so all these are directly linked to the inclusive growth strategy which has been formulated by the government. And PPP, again, how the partnership should be, should only government will be focusing, the role of CSR, very important, corporate social responsibility, which has been incorporated in the Companies Act amendment of 2013. So how it is participation can be increased, what are the incentives, what can be some of the incentives given to private sector to participate in this model, any success models related to that, all these can be possible questions. If you refer to Kurukshetra and all, you can see some of the success models related to that. And also industrial, every aspect, if you take industry, service sector, social sector, health, education, from an inclusive point, or it is benefiting all from an equity perspective, how the questions can be framed, this can be asked. And also that is the changing trend of UPSC questions. And also, again, very important, sectoral and regional diversification, because how the certain sectors, that is why certain areas has been focused, Northeast area. Now the government is announcing separate SOPs for Northeast areas, which is related to agricultural industries or the rural industries. Certain other areas, which is focusing as a steel, that East or the India region, because of our resource increase and all, there is development as a steel hub. And also some of the advanced states, what can be done to the upward there, some of the problems arising out of their development and all. Take the case of Punjab, what are the issues there? So a focus, area specific focus is also giving. From a planning from the top, now it is changing to a more decentralized level, because the issues of different states are different. That is the aspect of Niti Aayog's main strategy. So these kind of areas are also very important. Now coming to the basic things, the government budgeting aspects, budget terminology, these are basic things actually. All these things will be important. And the fiscal policy and the taxation as such, what are this? Actually, this term itself, this was from economic survey, this thin balance sheet syndrome. Because the crisis in both the corporate sector and NPS, this was termed as thin balance sheet syndrome. Or the Chakravyuha issue, this was another term, Chakravyuha. Because a company, if it decided to exit India also, there are a lot of formalities. That was defined as Chakravyuha in economic survey. So that is why certain terms in economic survey itself can be a possible question for our mains. Now coming to this monetary policy and the finance system, basic things only. Another banking sector. Banking sector also, we can expect some possible questions related to the merger of banks, how it is helping. Again, connected with the bad banks, will it clean up the Indian banking sector or the crisis of NPA? And the other, the NBFCs, how they are performing, or the NBFCs issues and all. So all these will be related, because these are current issues. That is the importance of these areas. Lot of activities, or the government is undertaking lot of initiatives for this problem. Mission Indradhanush, or the merger of banks, some banks has been merging. All these activities government is under, even insurance reforms. Again, very important. Or certain reforms in general insurance sector or the life insurance, lot of these activities are government is doing. Even the LIC IPO, that itself can be indirectly asked. So all these things are very important. So lot of these activities are happening in the money market and capital market, which can be a possible questions in our mains. And also again, financial inclusion, we know about the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana and the Jam Trinity, all these things. This again, the review of these kind of policies, how it is success, has it been, has it led to some of the women empowerment, all these things from a sectoral perspective, or does it reduce the sectoral imbalance, all these things will be asked. Now coming to the Foreign Trade and International Organization, again the role of WTO, you can always expect a question from that area, because after the Trump is gone and the Biden has come, how it is changing, lot of initiatives to counter BRI, we know that will be important from a GS2 perspective, but it can be also linked to GS3 from an economy perspective, like the Build Back Better initiative, which has been proposed by the G7 nations, how it will be functioning, or the new changing dynamics of US, China and all these things. Trade war has been stopped from when that level to a next level. All these things will be important. WTO will be important, and the trade deals India has undertaken, and because of India not joining APEC or our RCEP, the RCEP India not joining and all, that will be also a possible area of questions you can expect. Now coming to almost economy part is done. Because that is almost, I will say, half of the area. If we divide economy into economy and agriculture, half of the questions from these areas, which includes the basic mobilization of resource or the planning and all development concept, inclusive all these things, and the government budgeting initiatives or the various investment models, the savings related, all these investment, all these things is on one hand, and also all other things, capital market, financial market, external sector, all these things on one hand. Now coming to agriculture as such, that is another big area. So what all will be covered in agriculture? Major crops and cropping patterns in various parts of the country. You can see that the questions like related to how the wheat, rice, a model of or the cultivation had affected, or how it became a bane for the Indian economy, these kind of things, or also directly questions about the National Millet Mission, all these things, or the do we need to change from our monocropping pattern, these kind of things you can expect from this major crops cropping pattern in various parts of the country. Now different types of irrigation, irrigation system storage, very important, the various methods like as dripper, sprinkler, all these things you can expect questions. Transport and marketing of agriculture produce, again very important, food processing will come here. Actually agriculture produce, how it will be changed, actually food processing will come here. Indirectly food processing is what it meant, because storage is a big issue in India. We know about the four issues like as availability and the accessibility, and the accessibility part is very important, and APMC reforms, agriculture bills, APMC reforms or the agriculture bill, all these things will be coming here. And also the issues related to direct and indirect farm subsidies and MSP, direct question, or the PM ASHA scheme, what are the alternatives to the MSP, because that is being lot of discussion, because all these agriculture farm bills, we can expect 2-3 questions from that area, or 2-3 areas, potential areas UPSC can ask questions, because lot of convergent activities, because it is related to agriculture cultivation, agriculture, the government says that it is related to agriculture marketing. So food processing will come, or the APMC reforms, ENAM, all these things will be related, or the corporate or the contract farming methods, all these things, how it will work, all these things will be coming under this area. And PDS, again we know, one nation one ration card, one nation one ration card. Okay, so this one nation one ration card, you might have remember related how the COVID-19 crisis India, because of these benefits, how the migrant laborers were affected. So this can be a possible solution, this, because there is no need of, if you take ration card from anywhere in the country, that will be valid in any other part of the country also. So all these things will be related, the PDS reforms or the food security, how it is planning, there are a lot of recommendation like Shantakumar committee, which is an older one. Now there is a talk of rationalization of this food security, and the food subsidy should be limited, all these things we can discuss, or the all aspects related to food security on one hand, and other hand we can see the global hunger index related issues, how India is tackling malnutrition, various schemes related to that, all these things will be important. Now coming to various technology mission related to agriculture, again itself like the biotechnology, nanotechnology, or the various for this crop insurance, how drones are used and how the technology is changing the lives of farmers, that can also be a possible question, and all the various revolutions related to that, which related to earlier green revolution or the horticulture revolution or the National Millet Mission, livestock, mixed farming, all these things can be also you can expect. Now expect or the economics of animal rearing, again directly food processing, again very important, I will say almost 90% one question directly or indirectly you can expect, because last 3-4 years if you look at the trend, food processing is a, what to say, a core area where UPSC is asking a lot of questions. And also if you look at the questions itself, just minute changes in this maneuverability is happening, you will be knowing, any serious aspirant who has been preparing for civil service mains will be knowing the various aspects. You just need to structure your question and you can score high marks, just connect it with the various schemes of governments, for example like the PM Sampada Yojana or the PM, the various missions of the government, just linked with that food processing sector, then you will be getting high marks for that question. Now land reforms, again that's an evergreen area, anytime you can expect question. And also effects of liberalization of economy, changes in industry, all these things. Now role of agriculture in Indian economy, again it is related actually, that is because still we know almost 50% of the Indian population depend on agriculture and just 16% is the contribution. So that is why the government is focusing on doubling farmers' income, lot of these kind of things. So all these are related, the sustainable land management, steps taken by government, again agriculture bills, very important. And the Niti Aayog's various report like this, that will be also important. And also land reforms, anytime you can expect a question, land reform, because that is a core part of our area which we are covering, and why the land reform was a failure and what are the alternatives ahead, and also land reform as such can be possible, all these things you can expect question. Now coming to agriculture finance, that is another area actually, features of agriculture finance, criteria for agriculture credit, what is the need for that, how it has empowered the lives of farmers, and also is it really helping, and the MG Narega, it is also related to that, the agriculture financing methods, and the role of cooperative sector or the cooperatives in substituting or in encouraging government mission towards this agriculture financing mission, all these things, how it is helping the small and marginal farmers, all these things will be important. And the role of cooperative credit society is very important again, because now there is a change, like a new cooperative ministry was formed. So again, it is a top area related to GS2, but you can always expect a question on GS3 also. Now, various credit institutions, how they are performing and all, the role of NABARD or the RBI, how it is tackling, all these things also will be important. Just have a brush on these things, because you can add up points. This is not directly linked to, I will say that in some of the questions related to agriculture finance, you can add the some of the agencies, how they are performing. For example, NABARD or the Kisan Credit Card Scheme or the government policy for agriculture credit, all these things, if you are able to bring these kind of points, that will fetch you more marks. Now, crop insurance, we know the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, the issues associated with that scheme, again that will be important. This agriculture, along with credit, the agriculture insurance is also very important. So this will be issues associated with these schemes. Changes happened in Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, why government go for such a change? So all these things can be a possible aspect of UPSC question. Again, agriculture marketing, again farm bill. So this year you can always expect lot of areas this farm bill has convergence. So farm bill can be a question in any of these areas. So you need to prepare from a 360 degree view what can be the possible aspects, because agriculture marketing, the government says that we are bringing the bill related to agriculture marketing only, because that was some of the issues related to center and states, because states were like that, agriculture is a state subject, the center was like, it is true, but we has bring a bill in related to the agriculture marketing, which is under commerce industry, which is a under concurrent list. So all these things, what are the agriculture marketing, what are the issues, all the agripreneurship, this is again very important, this term and all, because one year the UPSC asked about what is allelopathy. Not allopathy, allelopathy. Okay, related to the agriculture reforms, how the farming should be done. Same way, agripreneurship, it can be a possible question. Or also related to the agriculture market, that's analysis of APMC Act, very important. So all these things you can expect. Now again, another evergreen topic of UPSC, this subsidies. You can always expect, because now rationalization of subsidies is talking about. Of that, fertilizer subsidies, very important from an agriculture perspective. Fertilizer and food subsidies. So how we know the issues related to stubble burning, because of our policies of subsidy only, that issue got more in the Punjab and the, those areas, because of our distorted subsidy policy, it has been affected. So government is now rationalizing the subsidy policies and all these things, especially fertilizer subsidy, subsidy on power, subsidy on irrigation, and the MSP anyway, and the impact of MSP on inflation, all these you can expect questions. And our food security bill, and now again connection with all these, the subsidy area is again connected to our agriculture or the new farm bills. Now again revolution, that is again you can expect always questions related to agriculture revolution, or which includes the new, like the National Horticulture Mission and all, NHM. And also food processing, again I am not repeating the same thing, you can expect always questions from food processing. And our industrial policies, what are the changes and all. Okay, actually coming to our sources, very important. Some of you might be confused about, some of you might be knowing you had focused on certain textbooks and all, but coming to sources, again I will say NCERT is very important, the class 10, class 11 and class 12. When it comes to class 12, that macroeconomics, which is required actually, especially chapters related to budgeting, open economy and state of economy. State of economy. So that is also important. Some of you might have skipped, it's okay, but I think I will, my recommendation will be just have a look at these two, three chapters, that will help you. Actually That is the base of this economics, because if you want a proper answer, because and to bring clarity on various concepts, you need a reading of macroeconomics of the plus two also. That is also very important. 10th and 11th, again 11th, very important, the economic development. Now you can see the changing trend in prelims, which can be also seen in mains also. This NCRT is the base. And coming to another text, this either Sanjeev Verma or Ramesh Singh. I'm not saying to read both of the books. You should follow either of the books. My suggestion will be Sanjeev Verma. That doesn't mean Ramesh Singh book is not. It is equally, if you started with Ramesh Singh, it's okay. Either of the books you can. And the economic survey, volume 1 and volume 2, very important. That is, most of the time we are seeing that a lot of the aspirants will be skipping this economic survey. Actually, direct questions you can see, or the direct where we will be thinking for, or where these words come from, the UPSC questions. Most of the time, a lot of these odds and terms which is used in the economic survey is being directly asked by the UPSC, or the analysis of the economic survey. That will be very important. So that is why this economic survey volume 1, we know for our exam preparation, that is the mains, volume 1 is important. Even volume 2, that will give you a lot of data you will be available, that authentic data you can quote in many of the introduction and conclusion. This authentic data, especially related to agriculture, infrastructure and all, this data will help you a lot. And also to have an analytical questions asked, give a trend of some public finance or the physical measures, debt and all, you can use this data. So both the volume 1 and volume 2 of economic survey is equally important. And Niti Aayog report, 3 years action agenda, again very important, you can expect. And also you can quote a lot of data or a lot of the authentic sources. UK will be giving a clarity on that part. Again, Kurukshetra magazine, that is again important, because sometimes this analytical questions, because we will be looking for a lot of other sources for economy and all, but most of the time we can see that this Kurukshetra and even Yojana also to an extent, but Kurukshetra is very important for economy and agriculture. And also newspaper, again without newspaper, because that page itself is very important. We need to up to date with the current events, because economy demands, like unlike other subjects, we need to update with the current events. For that, newspaper reading, especially business page, how the RBI policy is changing or the government policies, especially the questions from or the RBI, the money market changes and the government policy, that is financial, the fiscal policy and taxation, that you will be getting from newspaper reading. Now we can look at the various questions, how the questions trend was asked. Coming to 2020, this was one question: explain intra-generational and intergenerational issue of equity from a perspective of inclusive growth and sustainable development. So for this, we will be knowing what is intra-generational and intergenerational equity, very important. Okay, so intergenerational, that you will be knowing actually, because the future and the current generation. Again, intra-generational, rich and poor. So if you know these terms, you can answer these kind of questions. Otherwise, you will be in a issue. You will not be able to give a proper answer. So that is why these kind of terms, that's why I already told you that this inclusive growth, or the growth means include sustainable development, these areas are very important because of the convergence of the questions from economy and environment. So that is actually a current affairs question. Again, define potential GDP and explain its determinants. What are the factors that have been inhibiting India from realizing potential GDP? Actually, it is a theoretical question if you see, but what is this potential GDP? When the economy is working at its full employment or the full utilization of resources, how it is, what GDP it can achieve? What are the determinants? We know a lot of issues related to infrastructure, logistics, or the structural issues in the Indian economy. If you mention those issues and what are the government initiatives, you will be having a better answer. So this is, again, this was from again economic survey. This issue was highlighted because why India is not able to achieve its fullest potential in GDP. So if you have some understanding, if you have go through the economic survey, you might have felt this question as easy one. Again, what are the main constraints in transport and marketing of agriculture produce? Again, agriculture related. Two questions from, one was, these two from, if you see, government budgeting or the concluding, this inclusive growth and issues arising from it, and the government planning and policies, this question. This is from agriculture. And again, look at that, food processing. Direct question, what are the challenges and opportunities of food processing sector in the country? How can the income of the farmers be substantially increased by encouraging food processing? So again, direct question. How is science interwoven deeply with our lives? What are the striking changes in agriculture triggered off by science-based technologies? Again, linkages, agriculture and technology. For this, we need some idea how the agriculture, for example, our insurance. Now the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, it is using drones. What are the changes in technology we are using? More scientific farming, or the our soil health card scheme. So, or we are focusing on precision agriculture. Tissue. Lot of these changes in technology is now integrated with agriculture. If you know all these things, you will be able to answer these kind of questions. Again, explain the meaning of investment in an economy in terms of capital formation. Discuss the factors to be considered while designing a concession agreement between a public entity and a private entity. Again, actually, that is a theoretical question related to investment models. What are the issues associated with role of investment? We know a lot of this public-private partnership or the new monetization program, all these things has been initiated by the government. So what are the factors while concession agreement, because a lot of projects are now in a PPP basis. We know about this viability gap funding. Lot of this major infrastructure projects is now on a PPP mode, it is being built. So there the interest of the government also need to be considered. Otherwise we see that because the loss of the mounting NPA is result of lack of proper agreements and all. So what are the factors to be considered? We need to consider viability factor, a long time planning, all these points we need to point out. For this we know what are the changing structure of government policies related to disinvestment or the infrastructure development, how government is now functioning. We can see the privatization of airports and also changing pattern of privatization, all these things are happening. So if you know that, again you can answer these kind of questions. Now again, GST, explain the rationale behind GST, how has COVID impacted the GST compensation fund and created no federal tension, directly from GST compensation and associated issues between center and state. Now another question, what are the, that I told you about this cropping pattern, changing cropping pattern, what are the major factors responsible for making rice wheat system a success? In spite of this success, how has this system become a bane in India? You need to quote like the issues of subsidy or the distorted subsidy, which is affecting the soil quality and the water quality and all. We need to change from this rice wheat to other diversification of crops. All these things will be what is asked in this question. Now coming to 2019, again you can see the question related to GST, enumerate the indirect taxes which have been subsumed in the GST. Now again the questions related to inflation and the GDP growth related question. Again, I had already told you during the syllabus discussion, this type of question you can expect. What are the impacts of low inflation and the GDP growth? Is it is good for economy or do we really perform well? All these kind of things. Now directly, how far is integrated farm system? Again, you can look that two questions from the core economy part. Again, agriculture related two questions is coming related to integrated farming system, helpful in sustaining agriculture production. Elaborate the impact of national watershed project. Two policy, that's what I said, that very important agriculture related policies are very important. Two direct questions related to, if you know these schemes or programs you can score high marks. If you don't know, that means almost our that question will be lost, because these kind of questions, it is not like a other pattern of analytical question. Directly they are asking about the various aspects of the schemes, so we need to know these kind of important schemes related to agriculture. Now coming to, again, it's a surprising question in 2019, how was India benefited from the contribution of Sir M. Vishwesharaya and Dr. M. S. Amna in the fields of water engineering and agriculture science? But this question, I will say, if you are able to bring some points itself, you will be getting high marks. Why? Because this is a surprise question for everyone. Everyone will be answering like a, or that perfect answer won't come from anybody, that's for sure. So these kind of questions we need to have approach. Don't be panic and just have our ideas in open. That will be, if you point out 2-3 points itself, 2-3 good points itself, you can get good answers, like how Vishwesharaya contributed to planning. What are the points we know? I know this is surprise questions. What is coming to mind related to these two great scientists? We can quote these points. Now again, it is argued that the strategy of inclusive growth is intended to meet the objectives of inclusiveness and sustainability. Again, the sustainability or the inclusive growth and issues associated with this. Look at the pattern of questions UPSC is asking. Almost similar type of questions, but just changing words, and we are asked to point out, just to make some changes in our structure of our answer. Again, the public expenditure management is a challenge to the government of India in the context of budget making. during the post-liberalization period, clarify it. Because how is changing? Because we know that we had limitations on this physical. That's why I told you that physical deficit this time the target has been overreached because of the COVID-19 crisis. So you can expect questions from that area. So that is only what that mean. Our physical deficit, revenue deficit targets, how it is affecting government spending. On one hand, government need to, because the demands has been, the change in demands, government must have withdrawn from some core areas. But the expenditure government is putting us has increased enormously on one hand, and there is limited sources for revenue. That is what is happening. The tax is not, the tax buoyancy is not happening, or our tax collection is not that much efficient, or that is not increasing at that level. So what are the challenges before the government to maintain this target, at the same time provide basic necessities to a substantial population of people? Again, what are the reform steps taken by the government to make the food grain distribute system more effective? We know the chair or the reforms in the PDS system or the ration card. I had already told you about one nation, one ration card. What are other changes? EPOS machines, the technology incorporation, all these things will be important. Elaborate. Again, look at that. The policy taken by government to meet the challenges of food processing sector. Again, almost repeated question 19 and 20 also. This question is also important. How can biotechnology help to improve the living standard of farmers? This can be not from a pure economic perspective. It is related to science and technology also. Now, coming to questions in 2018. Access to affordable, reliable and sustainable and modern energy is the sine qua non to achieve sustainable development goals. The question on SDG and energy linked. The SDG 7 target. Again, direct question related to SDG goal. This question is also was important. Comment on the important changes introduced in respect of the long-term capital gains and dividend distribution tax in the union budget for 2018-2019. It's a factual question. If you are clear with this idea only, you may be able to write this question. Actually, that's a current affairs question, because one change has happened related to the capital gains tax and the some reforms in, that's why I told you that any reform in direct tax, indirect tax we had covered about GST, but direct tax reforms also, any proposal of the government will be important. If you know that only, we are able to answer this substantially, because they are asking to comment on these two. Because if you don't know what are the changes happened in this long term or the capital gains tax and DDT, we won't be able to have a proper answer. So we need to update it. That is very important. That's the role of this, looking at this economic survey and budget along with the newspaper analysis will be very important from a mains perspective. Now again, direct question, what do you mean by MSP? How will MSP rescue the farmers from the low income trap? Nothing to explain these type of questions. If we got these kind of questions, we'll be happy. Actually, finally we got a direct question which we can score very good marks. Again, examine the role of supermarkets in supply chain management of fruits, vegetables and food items. How do they eliminate the number of intermediaries? Linked to farm bills, you can expect these kind of questions. The supply chain management, that is the from production to till it reaches the consumer. There also the role of food processing, storage facilities, lack of storage facilities in India, lack of marketing facilities, all these will be important. So this farm bill has incorporated all these concepts. So you can again expect a question related to this area. Now, Sikkim is the first organic state in India. What are the ecological and economical? That was important in that year only. Again, about the organic state concept or the organic farming. Not much importance as of now. At that time, that was an important current affairs topic. And also now you can see that the challenges of organic farming which has happened in Sri Lanka. So, if over dependence of a sudden Sri Lanka has withdrawn all the fertilizer, chemicals, all these things, how they affected them. So, again, this organic farming should be more scientific, or various types of this farming methods like the cropping patterns, are we a question on even the GM crops also you can expect, because do we go for more scientific farming or the precision farming, all these things are possible questions from UPSC because of the target of 2022 of doubling farmers income. Again, what are the principles followed by, what are the principles followed by Niti Aayog different from those followed by the erstwhile Planning Commission in India? Direct question. Next one, how would the recent phenomenon of protectionism and currency manipulation in the world trade affect macroeconomic stability of India? At that time, it was a big issue actually, effect of liberalization, because it was related to the US-China trade war crisis. Now also, this area is very important. okay, this area again will be very important because the changing pattern of trade, because there is a movement to counter China by the G7 and all. You can expect India is also part of that initiative led by USA, Build Back Better initiative and all. Again, what are the changing this area? Again, you can expect some questions. Now coming to assess the role of National Horticulture Mission in boosting the production, productivity and income of horticulture farms. How far is BHAN succeeding in increasing the income of farmers? Direct question related to again one mission of the government. Again, look at that. Integrated farming system, National Watershed Project, now National Horticulture Mission. Already in the 3 years, we can see three key missions related to agriculture or the agriculture related activities has been asked by UPSC. Now again, how has the emphasis on certain crops brought about the changes in cropping patterns in recent past? Elaborate the emphasis on millet production. Again, that rice wheat which was asked in 2018, it was about another one, how the national millet program on millets is helping from a changing from rice wheat or the more into a soil based or a climate based, from our MSP we are changing. So this kind of question is a usual pattern, usual trend UPSC is repeating. Next question, with growing energy needs, should India keep on expanding its nuclear energy program? Discuss the facts and discuss the facts and fears associated with nuclear energy. This was actually a question related to that energy sector or the energy area. This question was asked. So with growing energy needs, should India keep on expanding its nuclear energy program? Among several factors for India's potential growth, savings rate is most effective one. Look at that, savings become again important. Role of savings in the investment formation was one question. So savings, the related to planning, mobilization of resource and savings will be again evergreen topic UPSC can ask question. Next one, account for the failure of manufacturing sector in achieving the goal of labor intensive exports rather than capital intensive export. Suggest measures for more labor intensive rather than capital intensive exports. Again, the role of our MSMEs or the promotion of India's jobless growth. There was also another question related to the jobless growth in India. This is the reason, more focus on capital intensive. That is why now government has changed the definition of small scale sectors, more focus on textile industries or the food processing rural areas and all. This is one of the initiative to provide more employment on one hand and at the same time provide more foreign or the export can be more generated. That is why still our manufacturing sector is an issue, our textile, including textile. That's why a lot of concentrating this PLI, production linked incentive schemes, are to boost manufacturing. India is aiming to have a manufacturing base in the next decade. So a lot of initiatives from government is taking. Directly some questions can also be asked from that area, Indian economy, because planning of resources and or like the PLI, production linked incentive, how it will help the manufacturing industry or make in India. You can always expect question related to make in India and all. So that is another area related to electronics, the focus on some of the key industries. Next one, examine the developments of airports in India through joint ventures under PPP. What are the challenges faced by authorities in this? Direct question related to PPP. Okay, so again, the other question was, they explained the various types of revolution took place in agriculture after independence in India. How does this revolution have helped in poverty elevation and food security? Direct question. This kind of questions are direct one because we know the answers. Again, what are the reasons for poor acceptance of cost effective small processing unit? How the food processing unit will be helpful to uplift the socio-economy? Look at that, how the changing from these kind of, I think if you now look at these questions feels easy because food processing, some direct questions, now it is changing from a more type of more diversification of questions is happening in food processing sector or the supply chain infrastructure itself. You can change that, see that changing trend. Next one, direct question from a budget perspective. Look at that. One of the intended objectives of Union Budget 2017-18 is to transform, energize and clean India. Analyze the measures proposed in the budget to achieve this objective. Again, budget related and policies, the key program of social sector or the social sector development like the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. It means like that, okay, transform, energies and clean India, clean fuel, all these things will be aspect. Again, next one, other question is, industrial growth rate has lagged behind overall GDP in the post-reform period. Give reasons. How far the recent changes in industrial policy are capable of increasing the industrial growth? Look at that, from direct questions related to the changes or the focus need to be given to manufacturing sector, because we know service sector was one of the main reason for the post-reform period we see this much growth. So now it is changing to manufacturing. This kind of simple question, now it is changing to a more complex type. about the manufacturing sector, how it can be, or the role of MSME, all these things. Now costings have been changing. Again, what are the salient features of inclusive growth? Again, look at this. Has India been experiencing such a growth process? Analyze and suggest measures for inclusive growth. Look at this kind of simple question. Earlier, like direct question related to inclusive growth or sustainable development was asked. Now it is changing to a more analytical type. We need to think more and we need to go into more dimensions. So we can expect this kind of question again also. Now another next question is, what are the major reasons for declining rice and wheat yield in cropping system? How crop diversification is helpful to stabilize the yield? Look at that, how much times this has been repeating, this rice wheat or changing cropping pattern, almost similar answers. We need to just make some maneuverability based on the question. Almost our content will be same, just need to structure that change, small change in structure. So we need to identify these kind of areas. This is one area, this rice wheat yield or related to the changing cropping pattern. Another is inclusive growth, similar type of question, 3, 4, 5 years almost repeating, related to budget like the GST and all. So these kind of areas we need to focus, and if we prepare for that, almost we can score high marks in GS3. Again, look at this, how do subsidies affect the cropping pattern, crop diversity and economy of farmers? What is the significance of crop insurance, minimum support price and food processing for small and marginal farmers? Again, this is a wider aspect which we had. Now they are integrating these questions as separate. It was asked in a, what to say, in single question about MSP, food processing, crop insurance and how it is helping small and marginal farmers. Again, coming to 2016, so this year onwards we can expect that, because 12.5 marks factor. How globalization has led to the reduction of employment in the formal sector of Indian economy? Is increased informalization determined to the development of the country? Still relevant. Again, also informalization, that is why labor or the labor law reforms is related to this only. Again, women empowerment in India needs gender budgeting. What are the requirements and status of gender budgeting in Indian context? One question related to Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, related to financial inclusion or the related to that kind of things. Single year, that was easy, direct question on that year. Again, what are smart cities? Examine their relevance for urban development in India. Will it increase rural urban differences? Give urban arguments for smart villages in the light of Pura and rural urban. Again, apart from agriculture, we can see questions related to other missions also, smart city, Amrut, all these things. Now Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, very important, you can expect questions from that area also. Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. Again, justify the need for FDI for the development of Indian economy. Why there is a gap between MOU signed and actual FDIs? Suggest remedial measures to be taken for increasing actual FDIs. Lot of changes had already happened. This was in 2016. Now we can see another dimensions of FDI will be asked, which all sectors, because lot of other sectors has been now FDI is allowed. So these changes, this is now happening, lot of FDI, because India has received a large FDI, one of the biggest recipient of FDI and all. So from other perspective, questions can be asked related to FDI. Is FDI coming as a real investment? There are some experts are saying these are not real investment. So these kind of angles which FDI can questions be also asked. Now coming to comment on the challenges for again inclusive growth, and which include careless and useless manpower in the Indian context. Suggest measures to be taken for facing these challenges. Actually, demographic dividend and all related things has been asked, demographic dividend. Next one, what is water use efficiency? Describe the role of micro irrigation in increasing water use efficiency. Drip and sprinkler irrigation. Directly they are asking. Okay, again, what is allelopathy? That's what I meant. Discuss its role in major cropping system of irrigated agriculture. A cropping pattern related question was asked. That's what I saw, had already told you about agripreneurship. A possible question can be asked. Again, discuss the role of land reforms in agriculture development. Identify the factors that were responsible for the success of land reforms. Direct question, because these are core areas. Again, given the vulnerability of Indian agriculture to the vagaries of nature, discuss the need for crop insurance and bring out the silent features of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. You can again expect question related to that area because of issues associated with this Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Next one, give an account of the current status and the targets to be achieved pertaining to the renewable energy resources in the country. Discuss in brief the importance of national programming on light emitting diodes. Again, that can be a surprising question related to that area. But again, COP26 is happening. We have set our ambitious renewable energy targets. This area, like the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, you can always expect a question. Now coming to 2015, the nature of economic growth in India's recent time is often described as jobless growth. Do you agree with this view? Give arguments in favor of your answer. You can see that if you compare the questions in the past, you feel more easier, more direct. You can feel that as compared to 2019 or 20, this year questions more direct question. Jobless growth and all, we were discussed a lot actually. Coming to another one, livestock rearing has a big potential for providing non-farm employment and income in rural areas. Discuss suggesting suitable measures to promote this sector in India. Related to agriculture only, how are the alternate sources of income to the farmers or the agriculture community? Again, the view of declining average size of land holdings in India, which has made agriculture non-viable for a majority of farmers, should contract farming and land leasing to be promoted in agriculture? Critically evaluate the pros and cons. Direct question. How can the Digital India program help farmers to improve farm productivity and income? What step has government taken in this regard? Again, direct question. In what way could replacement of prices subsidy with the DBT change the scenario of subsidies in India? Again, direct question. At that time, DBT has only brought that time. Now we are seeing lot of changes related to DBT or the JAM Trinity and all. Another one. What are the impediments in marketing and supply chain management in developing food processing industry in India? Can e-commerce help in overcoming this bottleneck? Food processing and e-commerce. Now we are seeing what are the changes happened. At that time, India was just starting on these kind of reforms. Now we are seeing the reforms happening as a result of the convergence of food processing and e-commerce. We know a lot of now local names and all. Another one that was also related to a scheme at that time. Craze for gold in India has led to surge in import of gold and recently put pressure on banks. So in which examine the merits of gold monetization scheme. At that time it was important. Again, Skill India program, one question related to what can be the pros and cons of that thing. Next one, to what factors can be recent dramatic fall in equipment cost and tariff of solar energy be attributed? What implication does the trend have for thermal? You see about nuclear energy, challenges of nuclear energy. Now solar power, we can always expect question related to the wind power. In this factor actually photovoltaic cells are important. We are still depending on China, the photovoltaic cells issue actually, or the tide, all these things we are depending. So wind power, again there can be a potential question related to wind power. So all this energy always a current topic because it is related to environmental aspect, and also coal crisis, recent coal crisis, you can expect some questions or the related to, or the gas line pipeline, how it is improving our thermal power sector more towards a clean energy and all. Next one, there is a clear acknowledge that CESS are a tool of industrial development, manufacturing and exports. Recognizing this potential, the whole instrumentality of CESS requires augmentation. Discuss the issue plaguing the success of CESS with respect to taxation, governing laws and administration. About the CESS only, especially economic zones, what can be the possible, what are the advantages or what are the issues associated with, and what can be the way forward. 2014 coming to challenges to internal security through communication network. Actually, this is more to a internal security, sorry for that. Okay. While we flaunt India's demographic dividend, we ignore the dropping rates of employment ability. What are we missing while doing so? Where will the jobs that India desperately needs come from? Explain, because that is why that disconnect is there. Jobs is not happening, jobless growth only, the concept of jobless growth or lack of skilling and all were the themes of this question. Next one, there is also a point of view that APMC set up under the States Act have only impeded the development of agriculture but also have been the cause of food inflation in India. Critically examine, again linked to our new farm law bills related to APMC reforms and all, how APMC had affected and all, how the farmers didn't get the original price and all these issues will be related. Next one, in the villages itself, no form of credit organization will be suitable, expect the cooperative society, role of cooperative sector only, they are asking directly from the what is the role of this cooperative and what are the constraints and challenges facing, how can technology be, this was before Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, not much importance as such now. Again, this question also not much importance now because right to fair competition, not much importance. Capitalism has guided the world economy to unprecedented prosperity. However, it often encourages short-sightedness and contributions to a wide disparity between rich and poor. In that light, correct adopt capitalism for bringing inclusive growth. Again, related to inclusive growth, the issues of inequality and all. Another one related to PPP projects only, directly. Next question, National Urban Transport Policy M7, moving people instead of moving vehicles. discuss critically success of various studies of government. Now we had traveled a long way. We know about the odd even schemes and the rise in metros, a lot of urban transport we are giving importance and all. Still long way to go, but the shift to more importance to public transport and all are the themes of this question. Again, FDA in defense sector is now said to be liberalized. This is also now a lot of changes can happen. Next level questions you can expect. Should the pursuit of carbon credits and clean development mechanism set up under UNFCCC be maintained even though there has been massive slide in the value of carbon credit discussed with respect to India's energy needs for economic growth? Again, at that time related to the Paris climate summit, before that only this question was asked. Here also the carbon credit, we have discussed a lot of the issue of carbon credit and all. Now we are moving towards the net zero and all, from not carbon credit. We are not discussing this kind of, because this kind of issues will be solved out soon, or this issue is not that much relevant now. Now we are discussing from another point of view. Again, not much important this question. Okay, with a consideration towards 2013, the strategy of inclusive growth, the new companies bill has indirectly made CSR mandatory. Discuss the challenges implemented. Now we are again come a long way ahead of this thing. Next one, what were the reasons for the introduction of Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act of 2013? Discuss critically its silent features and effectiveness. This is important because of our exceeding of the targets of fiscal deficit. Next one, what is the meaning of tax exemption taking house? This is also not important because at that time only, just important for a 1 year perspective. Food security bill is expected to eliminate hunger and malnutrition in India. Critically discuss various applications in effective implementation along with the concerns it has generated in WTO. Okay, food security bill, we know about the discussion now, that also gone a long way. India is still reluctant because of our food security, because if that what WTO says is allowed, that means we will have less bargaining power. So we are still, this issue is still alive. India is going ahead with our food security programs or the National Food Security Mission. Next one, what are the different types of agricultural subsidies given to farmers at national and state level? Critically analyze agriculture subsidy, the reference to the distortion created with it. That is why there is a changing from this direct kind of subsidy to more productive type of programs. Next one, India needs better measures to promote the pink revolution food industry. That question. Examine the impact of liberalization of companies owned by Indians. Are they competing with the MNCs? Satisfactorily discuss. You can expect these kind of things. Actually, even Indian MNCs has been grown very much. So we can have a critical analysis of these kind of questions. Establish relation between land reforms, agriculture productivity, elimination of poverty in Indian economy. Discuss the difficulties in designing and implementation of agriculture friendly land reforms. This is again an issue. That is why we know about this contract farming and all. And also now more freedom to farmers and all. By the failure of land reforms, we are putting it another way to increase productivity, earlier distorted subsidy, all these things. These are again contemporary issues we are discussing. So we can again expect our change in policies, why we policies changed to this aspect. Next one, discuss the impact of FTA entry into multi-trade retail sector on supply chain management in commodity trade pattern of economy. Again, FTA is happening in every sector. You can always expect the impact of FTA in various sectors. Through India allowed FDI is what is called a multi-brand retail through the joint venture route in September. The FDI even after a year has not picked up. Discuss the reason. At that time only, not much relevant now. Discuss the rationale for introducing GST. Okay, directly about GST, another question. We know, we have discussed GST a lot. Write a note on India's green energy corridor to elevate the problems of conventional energy. Okay, green energy, that is also directly program based. Last one, adoption of PPP model for infrastructure development of the country has not been free of criticism. We know PPP, what are the pros and cons of PPP? So this is about the questions actually. So now you will be getting an idea on, okay, where the questions, where all, which all areas we need to focus. So my final take is that agriculture and related cropping patterns related to rice, wheat and all, that is one area you need to focus, or the changing cropping pattern, what are the various schemes related to that, like the to reduce double burning or the diversification of crops and all, you can expect question. Next related to agriculture is food processing. You can always expect food processing or the supply chain management or for the improvement of rural economy. What are the initiatives related to that? That area you can always expect a question. Another, coming to another agriculture is the changes or the critical analysis of the various subsidies and the agriculture technology programs such as Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, the soil health card, and the credit system, insurance, these areas you can always expect a question. That is another area we need to focus related to agriculture. So almost agriculture, all aspect from the pre-sowing stage to the marketing stage we can expect, and also the value addition like the food processing areas will be important, and equally important is the poverty and the food security connection such as the reform in the PDS. Now coming to core areas of economy, this fiscal policy, now GST, again GST is important, but equally important is the reforms in the direct tax code, or the direct tax reforms which has been discussing at the international level itself of a single corporate tax rate. So that area, direct tax reforms, you can expect a question. Anyway, another is again this inclusivity and sustainability. Because of the climate summit which is happening, lot of discussion is going on about economy versus environment, energy versus environment, that area again various dimension, how like the last year intergenerational equity, they can go into beyond that, how it is the impact of various kinds of people or some schemes, the impact of certain schemes on reducing that issue, you can always expect a question on that part. Because inclusive growth, sustainable development, this equity aspect will always be important. That can be linked with some agriculture activities also, how our agriculture become productive and all. This kind of area also you can expect some question. So that is another area you need to focus, because looking at the trend we can see that. Again, the national monetization pipeline and the disinvestment, all these will become again important because of the change in government policies related to the raising of investment. More investment is needed. Related to that is the bad bank, the introduction of bad bank, and how it will be improve the banking sector of the country, or how it will clean up the issues related to NPS and all, that area also you can expect question. So these are some of the key areas you should need to focus. And also economic survey, again I am repeating, economic survey this year, last year, which will be very important. You need to go through the economic survey. That will serve you a lot of purpose, that will give you a lot of data and a lot of authentic things to quote in various answers, and you will be able to quote some examples related to, for example, some success related to small scale industry, or some success related to agriculture, some of the best methods of taxation or the tax collection, you can quote from economic survey. So economic survey is very important, so you need to look at that. Along with that, the various editions if possible of Kurukshetra and all, you can get into your core syllabus. And along with this, I am sure that lot of this repeated question, if you look at that pattern which I had repeated, certain areas if you focus, you can definitely score good marks from economies. 8 questions will be almost sure, 100 marks you can, out of the 100, high chance you can got 70, or the from that itself of the 100 you will be getting 50, 60, 65 marks is assured if you are preparing properly. Because you can expect some direct questions also, no need to have a more analytical, almost direct points you can quote in your answers. So that's all for our analysis of economy and agriculture. I hope this was helpful for all you. So we will be continuing our analysis with further other subjects. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.